गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वन सेकेंड वेलकम इन DSS ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। दिस इज सी यादव एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट आवर रेस्ट रीडिंग पोर्शन ऑफ सिविक्स चैप्टर सेकेंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग सेकुलरिज्म। आवर टुडेज फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज व्हाट इज इंडियन सेकुलरिज्म। लेट्स स्टार्ट रीडिंग। The Indian Constitution mandates that the Indian state be secular. According to the Constitution, only a secular state can realize its objectives to ensure the following. First, that one religious community does not dominate another. Second, that some members do not dominate other members of the same religious community. Third, that the state does not enforce any particular religion nor take away the religious freedom of individuals. The Indian state works in various ways to prevent the above domination. First, it uses a strategy of distancing itself from religion. Strategy may be a difficult word for you. Strategy means scheme. The Indian state is not ruled by a religious group and nor does it support any one religion. In India, government spaces like law courts, police stations, government schools and offices are not supposed to display or promote any one religion. In government school in Shimapur, students want to celebrate a religious festival, government high school. So, there is a big religious festival next month. We have never celebrated it in school. Can we do it this year? I am afraid that is not possible, Rekha. This is a government school. We cannot give importance to any one religion. Private schools maybe do that. Government schools don't celebrate any religious festival in the school premises. Most religious festivals are public holidays so that we can celebrate these at home. So, I never thought of it this way. I guess we can always celebrate it outside school. Anyway, we were planning to celebrate it in our locality. In the above storyboard, the celebration of the religious festival within the school would have been a violation of the government policy of treating all religions equally. Government schools cannot promote any one religion either in their morning prayers or through religious celebrations. This rule does not apply to private schools. The second way in which Indian secularism works to prevent the above domination is through a strategy of non-interference. This means that in order to respect the sentiments of all religions and not interfere with religious practices. Sentiment means persuasion. The state makes certain exceptions for particular religious community. A group of friends who have recently bought scooters are meeting to go for a ride together. Hi, I hope you have a helmet. You know, the law in Delhi requires that you wear one. Why are not you wearing a helmet? Do you want to be fined? Don't worry, I will not be fined. Hi Paramjit, why won't you be fined? For Sikh, wearing a pagri is a very important part of our religion. The government cannot force me to wear a helmet. In the above storyboard, Paramjit the Sikh youth does not have to wear a helmet. This is because the Indian state recognizes that wearing a pagri turban is central to a Sikh's religious practice, and in order not to interfere with this allows an exception in the law. Recognize. I think recognize, this word may be difficult. Recognize means diagnose. The third way in which Indian secularism works to prevent the domination listed earlier is through a strategy of intervention. You read earlier in this chapter about untouchability. This is a good example where a member of the same religion, upper caste, Hindus, dominate other members, some lower caste, within it. In order to prevent this religion-based exclusion and discrimination of lower castes, the Indian constitution bans untouchability. In this instance, the state is intervening in religion in order to end a social practice that it believes discriminates and excludes, and that violates the fundamental rights of lower caste who are citizens of the country. Similarly, to ensure that law relating to equal inheritance rights are respected, the state may have to intervene in religion-based personal laws of communities. The intervention of the state can also be the form of support. The Indian Constitution grants the right to religious community to set up their own schools and colleges. It also gives them financial aid on a non-preferential basis. I think preferential may be a difficult word for you. Preferential means discriminatory. In what way is Indian secularism different from that of other democratic countries? Some of the above objectives are similar to those that have been included in the constitution of secular democratic countries in order in other parts of the world. For example, the First Amendment of the US Constitution prohibits the legislature from making laws respecting an establishment of religion, or that prohibit the free exercise of religion. What is meant by the word establishment is that the legislature cannot declare any religion as the official religion, nor can they give preference to one religion. In the USA, the separation between state and religion means that neither the state nor religion can interfere in the affairs of one another.